Hello everyone, it's Erik Snopko. Today I will share my approach on how to make an orchestral mockup from start to finish using only the Synchron Prime Edition by Vienna Symphonic Library. So without further ado, let's listen to the Buckbeak slide by John Williams. Buckbeak's flight has a rich orchestration, making it a great example to study orchestral music programming. The first thing I set up after I transcribed the piece was to adjust the tempo map to fit the original recording. I recommend doing this also with your original compositions, as adding slight tempo variations will make them sound natural. Apart from tempo, some other elements influence realism. Dynamics, articulations, and other musical parameters like vibrato or harmonization. For all instruments, I use the velocity crossfade sus preset, which means that short articulations are controlled by velocity and long notes by CC1, your modulation wheel. To learn more about the other presets, I recommend to check out this video. Now I will go through each orchestral group and I'll show you some editing details and tricks. When I'm programming strings, I often use at least two controllers, velocity crossfade and expression. The modulation wheel, MIDI CC1, is used to crossfade between different recorded velocity layers, controlling velocity xfade. Expression, MIDI CC11, is used to automate the volume. Now, you may ask what master volume MIDI CC7 does then. Master volume also controls the loudness, but it's usually only used to set the gain staging of the instrument. I recommend setting it up once and leaving it untouched. I use expression to exaggerate the movement of modulation. This way, I can render a more dynamic performance. Additionally, I use timbre adjust on the violins to give them a fuller sound by taming the high frequencies. Some controller patterns repeat a lot in music programming, and that's the beginning and end of a musical phrase. Usually, you want to start a phrase quietly and also end it like that. It's the ending notes that are always challenging to program. Luckily, there is an option for soft release. Also, when the melody rises, there is usually a tendency to increase the dynamic intensity. This piece, however, has a quite lot of parts where this is not true, which just proves that there are no strict rules to follow. Furthermore, if there is a part that has no controller automation and sounds good, let it be. Like the MIDI Jedi say, don't move the slider just to move a slider. Regarding articulations, Synchron Prime Edition contains the essential ones derived from the more expensive Synchron libraries. For the strings, I mostly used legato and pizzicato. I sprinkled in some sforzatos to get a stronger attack here and there. Now, let's check a few tricks to make some sections sound more realistic. For example, I layered tremolo with double staccato notes to add more randomness to the viola part. Additionally, to create a stronger vibrato for the violins, I created a custom patch where I layered the legato with tremolo. That simulates the molto vibrato articulation, which is available in the Synchron Strings Pro. Unlike strings, woodwinds and brass cannot play the notes indefinitely, as they need to breathe. That's why you should leave some gaps between non-legato notes to create an authentic performance. This is especially true for the low brass. When I'm programming brass dynamics, I use the CC controllers in a slightly different way. The brass instruments are very dynamic, meaning there is a great contrast in sound when playing piano and fortissimo, and this makes it more difficult to create a seamless crossfade between the available dynamic layers. Therefore, VSL developed a special controller called Timbre Adjust to make these transitions smoother. For me, the Timbre Adjust feature became the main tool to shape dynamics when programming brass. I use Velocity Crossfade with the modulation wheel to choose the right dynamic layer, and then I draw an additional automation line for Timbre Adjust. Note that with Timbre Adjust you can only make the brass sound less piercing, not louder, so if you want to access the loudest dynamics, you should set both Timbre Adjust and Velocity X Fade to the maximum value. Similarly with woodwinds, I'm also using Timbre Adjust, but usually just to make the loudest dynamics sound softer. You might not realize this, but the realism of woodwinds can be also affected by the template setup. There are two common approaches when setting up a template. One is to use it like me here, with each instrument on one dedicated MIDI track. The main benefits are that your screen is less cluttered and you have a better overview of the piece. The other option is to have multiple MIDI tracks for each articulation of one instrument, so you don't have to use key switches and you could set a different track delay and mix for each articulation. However, with this option, you lose the ability to have a legato transition after a short note, which I think is especially important with woodwinds, as they often do this while playing fast phrases. Moreover, you can set a different delay and mix for individual articulations inside the Synchron player. So the main benefit left with this second classic approach is that you don't need to use key switches, but this can also be avoided by using special articulation mapping features of your DAW, like expression maps, sound variation, articulation sets, etc. Probably the easiest orchestral group to program is percussion, as they usually play short notes except for rolls. You just have to use the right velocity and make sure to accentuate the right notes. Additionally, to help them sound less robotic, you can use the humanized delay features, but make sure they are actually loaded in the edit tab. Thank you very much for watching, and hit the subscribe button if you want to see more videos like this. Bye!